Hello, everybody. Good morning, or depending on where you're at, maybe good afternoon, good evening. If you're a different part of the country than I am, for me, it's 10 a.m., and I can't wait to tear into some all-American packs I've had sitting here for a little bit. I think I bought the bundle the night of release when these went live. I had some extra Microsoft points sitting in my account after picking up Trials Evolution, which is an awesome game to play around with. My kids love it too. But anyway, thought, hey, put it towards some all-American packs. If you haven't seen my video on the breakdown of how these go yet, I guess I can start by showing you that. I'm going to refresh my stream page here so I can see your comments. And let's see how we do here. Looks like we're live. Good. Looks good. Okay. So, good morning, everybody. So, I just see a tweet going out from Mr. Hurricane. So let me just tell you what's going down. I talked to him this morning. He's going to stream at noon, so 2 hours from now. So the plan is for me to stream until then, and then filter all you guys over to Hurricane. So you guys are in luck. You get, well, at least, I don't know. I'm guessing he'll go a couple hours. I would think you get a good at least, 4 hours straight of streaming NCAA 14 if that's what you're excited about. So Orleans Operator is here. I see him here in the chat. Of course, we've got Sports Talk Live 13. Hey, buddy. Gamer 360 Sports is here. There's a Skater Boy's here. Just a few that I see in the comments so far. Can I put cards up for 150 coin? We'll see. I don't know. I don't know how this is gonna go. Obviously, there's reserves. I don't need to keep, every average card in reserve, but let's just see how it goes, shall we? And then I'll probably open the packs. I'll probably put most into reserves, and then we'll kind of, do, if we're gonna do any auction or anything like that, we'll do that after the fact, I guess. Is most likely the plan. So, All American Pack will run you 96 Microsoft points. Now, I think this might be on the season ticket scale, so if for you it's a little bit more and you don't have season ticket, that would be why they usually do a 20% discount for DLC and things like that in games that are, the season ticket games for EA. So 96 Microsoft points or 7,500 coins for an All-American pack. You can get a 7-pack bundle. Let's see, that goes for 640 Microsoft points, which is what I did. And that one you cannot use coins on. So, that saves you 23% over just buying 7 individual packs. Okay, so then they got a 15 pack for 1280, which is what, $20, right? And again, you can't use coins. You can get 38 pack. Now this says season ticket. Well, they all say season ticket next to it. So, I don't know what the price is if you don't have season ticket, but this is 3,200 Microsoft points if I were to get it. Again, no coins on the bundles. I don't know why. And I put the video up on this, and I was a little surprised that people were kind of up in arms about bundles. Bundles have been in Madden. They had bundles this last year, and some people are like, well, yeah, but you could use coins. But yeah, but it was a ton of coins to get the bundles, so I don't know. It is what it is. They're obviously trying to make money. That's, the big thing for Ultimate Team is that they do, make a chunk of money on the transactions. Outside of the people who just use coins, I tend to not put a whole lot of money, real money into this. I did here because I had the Microsoft points already in the account, and it's not like I was gonna get actual money back for them. I had to use them on something, so why not this? Okay, and then they have the 50 pack bundle. Did I mention that one? 4,000 Microsoft points for 50 packs. Can you imagine? And then and that also, when you get into these upper level packs, you get a bonus, either one or two bonus 93 plus rated players. So, most popular, I don't know why. I think they can just put whatever they want there. Most popular, it's really not a heading. Non-pack items, You can buy your game extensions and injury recoveries. You don't have to get them at auction. So I would suggest, if I were you, don't buy a 25 game extension for any more than 800 coins, or on auction anyway, because you can get them here always for that price. Injury recovery, 5-game injury recovery will cost you 300. So don't pay more for that same card on the auction house. Come here and get it. And if you ever run into a snag, you know, for years on Ultimate Team, I've heard people say, you know, oh, can you float me a card or something, because I can't play, I've run out of contracts. Well, you should be able to take care of that now. They did this in Madden last year too, where you got guys who are starter pack variety, freshman cards, and, you know, they're not going to be great players, but if you're, you know, say you lose your right tackle and you just have no one at that spot, well, you can go get 25, for 25 coins, you can get a placeholder, basically, get someone in your lineup where you can at least play a game. So it's nice if they do that. If you just simply kind of spaced it and don't have a contract for somebody and you need that position, you can at least come in here and get it with a very minimum of coins. So, and then beginner packs, gold starter team upgrade. This is definitely a way to go, not by coins, because it's 75,000 coins, but if you have any spare Microsoft points around, any at all, and you can scrounge up 64 Microsoft points, this is a really good way to go starting out, because you get 10 gold players. Now, I believe they're the same every time, but they're, you know, like 85, 86 rated. So that's a good way to boost your team right to the start if you're having problems, and, you know, if you have those points laying around. I suggest that. I did that. Also, as a strategy that, you know, kind of makes some sense, if you want to go buy those. Now, like, I don't know, like, the market, I haven't checked on the players that came with that, but somebody was saying a good strategy is, you know, buy that and then, you know, go put those out in the auction house for 1,000, you know, roughly a piece, and you should make coins, and then, you know, theoretically you could do that over and over, but, you know, you probably don't want to burn the Microsoft points, but, you know, whatever, it is what it is. So, you know, obviously the buy low, sell high strategy works really well for, like, my buddy Jamil the Killer on the auction house. So there's ways to gain coins that way too. I've done a little bit of that, just minor moving of like Peyton Manning 94 overall cards. You know, buying them for 2,500 less than I sell them. So I'm up to a modest almost 20,000 coins, not quite. Does Coleman play Pokemon? No, he's not into Pokemon yet. The kids are very much into Skylanders. I'm going to have him start a Skylanders series on his channel because he very much wants to. I have to have him play a little more Star Wars to continue that for his channel too. How much money have I spent on the game so far? I haven't, other than those points that were already around. So 640 Microsoft points. That's what I've spent. I did not go buy Microsoft points for the sake of doing that. I already had them, so I decided to use them towards this. But other than that, I've not spent any money on the game. I got some rewards for, you know, doing the demo. I think also for season ticket. I should be getting season ticket packs once a week. That's how it's worked in all the other games. I don't see any reason why it wouldn't be that way in this one. So. Yeah, what's the speed on the Chris Johnson freshman card? Okay, I can check that for you. I know Hurricane was hypothesizing that it should be a pretty fast card. I don't know that you can... Oh, you can. His speed's an 86. 80 agility. 72 acceleration. Acceleration could be better, but hey, you know, it's a 64 overall card with 86 speed. I mean, that's probably... Yeah, that's quite nice. It's quite nice for 25 coins, really. I mean, what are Sanchez's stats? I'm just curious. It's pretty decent injury rating. I'll give him that much. So, yeah, there's my packs. Okay, before I do that really quick, I know that's what we're going to do. So, I know some people were asking... is this just going to be packs, or I'm going to play a game? I think I'm going to open the packs, and I think I'll play at least one game. I plan to go till noon here, or 2 hours. So, is this game worth $60? I definitely think so. By the way, my review is up, guys. My review of the game, I can't leave links. Oh, but I could in the description. Hold on a second. Let me do this. In case anybody's interested in reading my official review of the game, with questions like that, I think you are. Let me just cut and paste this into the description here. I'll put it under the NCAA 14 Ultimate Team playlist. I'll say, Niners fans, NCAA 14 review. And I'll cut and paste that link. Save it. There. Okay. So now if you refresh the page, you'll be able to see under the about or description of this video, it's the second link there. There's a link to my playlist for Ultimate Team on SGU, and there's a link to the Inside Gaming Daily Machinima blog where the review is. So what does my lineup look at like? I will show you that as well. I think I'm an 89 overall. How have I gotten my coins, PsychBaller32 asks. And the question, the answer is a lot of them on offline challenges. So far I've done, let's take a look at offline challenges here. I've done just a very few in the conference ones. Just two kind of to start with there. Once you get down to the end of conferences, I guess these are all just coins. I thought maybe some of these were packs. That's coins. That's one way to make coins rather easily. Okay, here's one. I had a video out on this yesterday. Bowl games, and now there's different. There's bowl games 1, 2, 3, and then BCS bowl games. All get progressively harder. This is the freshman difficulty set, but it got a gold reward pack. Basically, it was a couple players and three contract cards, one of it all, each variety that I got for that. But there's a video up on that, so you can check that if you want. Jamila's here. Hey, Jamila. Wait, how are you watching? I thought you were working or something. Did you call off? You got up to 350K already? Man, I told you. I was telling these guys. The buying and selling, yeah, like, you know, he's a master at it, especially in Madden Ultimate Team, and, you know, I mean, obviously no different here. He knows how to work the market. You just got to look for, you got to know which cards are in demand. You got to look for one that kind of goes up a little bit lower than expected, buy it up, and turn it around. But, you know, obviously it helps to have some coins to be able to purchase them, to be able to flip them, so... But that is, I would say the number one strategy. If you want to get coins fast, watch the auction house. Look for things that go like that. You hate the 24-hour minimum sell period. What do you mean? 24-hour minimum sell? No. I post mine for 1 or 2 hours. I don't know. I've been able to. Did they change something that I didn't know about? Yeah, I've been able to sell for one or two hours. I'll show you. So anyway, and then there's the Heisman challenges, which you need to complete some collections to start first. But, you know, they're here. We'll get into that stuff later on. And then there's the weekly challenges. I did some of these. I did the ESPN Game of the Week. That was just 1,000 coins. But these will change weekly. Community Game of the Week I have not done yet. I probably will here at some point. I did both rivalry ones, and that got me a gold reward pack. And yeah, so those are the offline challenges. That's, I mean, to get some coins right away, start doing those, because a lot of them are quite easy on freshman, you know, difficulty. The difficulties are locked in. Amazing review. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, I really felt like some of the outlets really brushed over this game, and I think it's unfortunate. The ones that stuck out of my mind were IGN and GameSpot, especially, because GameSpot, went as far as to say that, like, they basically said no new modes. I mean, I'm paraphrasing here, but they said, like, same old game, no new modes, gave it a 6. Yeah, but they never even mentioned Ultimate Team. Are you kidding me? I mean, how could you say that and then in the same breath not mention Ultimate Team? I mean, it right there, it just, you know, it just discredited the whole thing to me. I'm like, really? I mean, if there's anything you're going to leave out, I left out, I think I mentioned it in my starting paragraph. I said something about Road to Glory, but if you were going to leave something out and you were going to say, same thing that we've seen before, you know, Road to Glory, because it hadn't been touched. I mean, it's the same as last year. Other than it's more fun to play with a running back now because of all the cut moves and stuff. But, you know, really, you know, what's changed? Nothing's changed about that. Okay, so there, I'll give you that. But if you're going to not, you know, gloss over Ultimate Team, I mean, it just tells me that you didn't pay attention to the game, really. I mean, that's stupid. I don't understand that at all. So that's my little rant about that. I felt like, you know, I could have rushed my review out, but I kind of wanted to see how Ultimate Team looked like once everybody kind of got the game, and you know, just my last minute, you know, feel of that, in case something changed on that. I think that was one of the things. I think some people went into Ultimate Team, felt like there was really nothing, you know, activated at review time or something, and just didn't pay attention. And I mean, really, it was one of the big additions of the game this year. So, just my two cents. But yeah, you can read my review. I like to think I did the game justice, but you know, obviously, I mean, I have no problem. Like I said this on Twitter. I have no problem with someone giving a game a low score if it's justified. But I mean, if you're just gonna like say, same old game we've always seen. Well, yeah, it's football. I mean, what did you expect? You popped it in and thought there was gonna be like, you know, tennis mini games or something. I mean, what was? It's college football. I mean, you build upon what you've done successfully and you make it better, and that's exactly what this game has done. The physics engine is great. It's an improvement over the Infinity Engine version in Madden 13. It's much tighter, much less of the shenanigans after plays and stuff like that, you know, and the new cut system on the right stick is slick. Interceptions look great this year. Really, really smooth system there. I mean, you know, but I mean, just to discount it and say same game. I mean, come on. Really? So yeah, for auctions, well, I'll show you that you can most definitely put things up for 1 or 2 hours. And that's the thing too. If you're going to sell, if you're going to buy and resell, don't put it for 24 hours. Put it for 1 or 2 hours so it gets to the top of the list and people notice it. Some of you saying that your auctions never sell. Also be realistic. Don't get a card and be like, oh, you know, I got a 94 overall Peyton Manning, I'll put it up for 60,000 coins. You know, I mean, be realistic. Look at what the market's doing first before you post something. You know, because if you search here, like I'm just going to do a quick search, and I'll do 99 overall. Just any player, 99 overall. Okay. And then what you're going to want to do is slide over to Buy It Now, Price, and Sort. Okay. So the cheapest 95 to 99 overall player is right here, you know, obviously, and that's probably the one that is most common, and you'll see him for cheapest, but like, okay, the cheapest Manning is 10,000 right now, and the next cheapest is 11,000, and then the 12,000. There's not much separation there, so like for me, there are fees for putting up some of the cards again this year. I know Madden Ultimate Team moved away from that the last year, maybe is it 2 years now, but so like you have to give up 500 coins just to post Manning. So keep that in mind. So at 10,000 plus 500 to post is going to put it at like 10,500 is my cost. And for the next one to be 11,000, there really isn't much separation. Now, if Manning showed up on this list for 6,000-7,000, I'd definitely buy him, and I'd bump him right below 10. I'd put him at like 99.95 or something like that, and I'd put it at 2 hours. And then, you know, it's always good to be the lowest one on there if you can do it. Now, obviously, other people have the same strategy, so they might beat you as well. But You just want to know what the market bears. Here, I'll go specifically for Manning because I know he's the only quarterback right now that's showing up in this. Okay, so there's roughly what? 10, 12, 15 of them here. And you can try to get one for cheaper that's maybe expiring, but you're going to get in a bidding war with somebody. So I do this, and now, see, there's actually two up for 10,000. So, right now I wouldn't buy one of these unless I saw it for like 8,000 or less. That's the strategy, if you're asking. And then sometimes you can get really lucky. Sometimes people discard things that they don't even know. See, there's one for 9. Again, if I really was hard up to try to make 500 coins, roughly, I could do it right now. That one was posted for 2 hours, you see, so it kind of gets up to the top of the list in a lot of categories. But the thing is then, you will have some people that, are rare for whatever reason. Maybe they're collection pieces and people are collecting them, and so they're more in... it's a dynamic market. That will not always be the going price. I mean, it might go down on that card. It might go up, depending on what the demand is and how many there are out there. So really, I just suggest before you put anything on the market, search that player you're about to put up, see what it's going for, be realistic. Because especially if you're going to, put 500 coins down a time or 100 coins or whatever it is for the listing price, you don't want to be wasting that. Be smart about what you put up. So you have a Manning 95 overall. If I want him, that's cool. But how? We're back to the archaic system. This is the one thing I wish they would have put the trades in, because how did we miss trades when Madden Ultimate Team knew that was an issue and they've worked? It's been in a couple of years and now we're back to the point where you got to do the 3-2-1 countdown to get a to try to time a card in the auction house. That's the one thing that I wish that would have made it in here was the trade feature. But, I don't know, maybe they can patch it later, title update, or maybe it waits till next year. But, I'm grateful to have Ultimate Team in here, and the way they did it is nice. So, anyway, let's get to some of these packs, shall we? Your friend sold 94 gold Tebow for 42K? Yep. There will be some cards that are, GameSpot didn't mention the new engine either. I missed that. Wow, they really screwed up. I'm sorry, but whoever reviewed that should not review football again. I'm sorry. They just shouldn't. Should not do it. Can I start a game? No, this is a pack opening. We'll play a game afterwards. But the main purpose of the day was to do some packs. So let's do that. Okay, so like I said, I bought a 7-pack bundle. That's what we'll be working with in this stream anyway. There might obviously there'll probably be more down the line, but let's get into this. Let's open our first one. Alright, what do we got? We've got Doug Baldwin from Stanford leading us off here. 70 overall wide receiver. Don't think that fits into my lineup. Hey, we got Albert. We got Albert for collectible suite. Maybe we can finish off one of the get something for collectibles during this. I think I already had Willy Wildcat, so maybe we can auction that one up. Well, actually no, because you can do multiples, so we'll save them up. 25 game extension. James Brewer from Indiana, right tackle. Colin Jones, free safety out of TCU. Got the George Dome for a stadium. That's kind of nice. 50 game extension. Notice we haven't hit our gold card yet. Oh my God! Is Burnsy in this stream? Burnsy, I got your quarterback. You probably already have him too. Maybe. I have a feeling you probably searched him and got him right away. But Burns is a big Boise fan, and I know his opinion on Kellen Moore. Yeah. 88 overall, not bad. Yeah, I get Mouton from Michigan. So I'm a Michigan fan. That was my base set when I started. I'm a Minnesota fan first and foremost, Gopher fan. I grew up and have lived in the Twin Cities most of my life, but born here. But I'm an adopted Michigan fan from way, way back. I went to Michigan football camp my senior year of high school. Got to stand out on the field at the big house. So yeah. Okay, so definitely I'm gonna, I guess I'll probably put Kellen into my lineup since I think he'll be a good backup and trade off there for starter for now. Let's see. I'll put that there as well. Game extensions will go those so that I can put them into collection. Okay, so make those current. I still wish that they'd make it so that you could put straight to collection from like reserves, that you wouldn't have to put them into current. That's kind of a pain. These guys will put in reserve for now. Okay, so there's one pack down. I don't want to get too flooded here on current roster, so let's just go. As we go through here, we'll look and see what we got. So I'm gonna go ahead and send these two to collection. Okay, so then I'm going to the players here. And for those of you who want to see my lineup, this will serve that purpose as well. Who is Burnsy? Oh, I'm sorry. It is XX the Burns 2211XX. Here, I can spell it out. He does videos. And I've played in his dynasties and stuff. Anyway, he's a good YouTube buddy of mine and a big Boise fan, so. So Luke Kuechly is my top overall right now. Then my punter. Thing I don't understand, has anyone explained this? When I pulled this Alex Smith card, it was a 94 overall, so I don't know if they just were like still working on their final ratings adjustments and that's how it got bumped, or is there some kind of dynamic system where they actually go up and down this year? I'm thinking it's the first option because I think that they might have realized or felt that they bumped him a little too high, and then because when I first pulled him, he was a 94 overall. He's now a 90. I think they just were tweaking during the review period time. And this one, I fully expect to be Nnamdi Asamoah again at some point. But I can understand what the problem because they had him as a free safety, and I don't know. Somebody said maybe it was a problem with his number as well. But anyway, right now the placeholder is default player 90 overall corner, but that's supposed to be Nnamdi Asamoah. So then you got Kellen Moore. I'm gonna do this by position, it's easier. And that's usually where I make my decisions on who to send to reserves and all that. So yeah, Kellen makes a good backup here at the moment here. And then I got Case. I got the 80 overall Aaron Rodgers. That's from doing the Nike Skills Trainer. If you guys haven't done the Nike Skills Trainer yet to get cards, do that because if you get a gold on each level, each different skill set in the trainer unlocks a card. So I'm terrible at them, so I've only unlocked like four of them. And Newton and Rodgers being two of them, and there was another Alex Smith that's an 80 overall. Unfortunately, yeah, three of the four were quarterback ones. So, and the other was Aaron Hernandez that got turned. Well, the Aaron Hernandez got turned into Alex Smith, but it's like you could have at least made a tight end equivalent, so I didn't have to have so many quarterbacks. But end of rant, I guess. So Newton, I guess I'll. Well, I didn't mean to do that yet. I keep Newton in the lineup for speed. 86 with an. I assume. He's my fastest quarterback. Although Alex Smith is an 82, really. Okay, so I guess I'll move Rodgers to reserve. I don't need that many quarterbacks right now. And hanging out with Bo and Barry here for the time being, just because they're kind of fun to have around here. Still just LeRon McClain at fullback, so that's definitely a position I'm hoping to upgrade with these packs or auction house. Wide receivers, I've got Santana Moss. Greg Salas is a relatively new one. I got that when I bought that that pack, that gold upgrade thing that gave you 10 cards. He was one of them in there. They're all like 85 and 86 overall players. Dwayne Harris, Keenan Allen, James Jones, and Nene. Now I know 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I like to carry 6 receivers. Once I'm thinking Nene is gonna go in reserves real soon here. If I pick up any wide receivers, and I'm sure I will here. So tight end, I'm rolling with Dwayne Allen as my top one. Jeff Cumberland is back up at the moment. Left tackle, Riley Reiff. Left guard needs an upgrade. Centers. Yeah, here was my other skills trainer when I got Barrett Jones. I got Jason Kelce out of Cincinnati as my starter right now. Right guard. This was one of my only auction house pickups. Early on, at least, that I didn't sell back. Craig Urbick got him for $3,000, I think, at the time. Game hadn't actually released at that point. Cordy Glenn. Left end, I'm running with Anthony Spencer out of Purdue. Right end, I probably don't need 3, but I kept 3 around because I was doing freshman challenges and trying not to burn out contracts. Your cat started intensely hissing when Cam came on the screen. That's funny. Whether it's true or not, that's funny. Yeah, so I'll probably be dumping him soon to reserves. At Terry Poe, Derek Landry at D-tackle. D-tackle's a spot where I could use a couple more since they play 2 at a time. If you run the 4-3, left outside linebacker. Man, we got room for improvement there. As in a lot of these spots. One thing I like is that there aren't like a plethora of 99 overall cards to start the year. Which is, I think, more how it should be. Luke at the middle here, obviously. I will, just telling you, I at some point have a Laurinaitis card. I've got that mine, that 95 overall. I probably should have bought it yesterday because it was at like 10, and it's now at 15,000 when I checked this morning. Average, so. Laurinaitis is my boy because we both went to Wayzata High School, so. Yeah. Right outside linebacker, Justin Houston out of Georgia. And I got a Lawrence Timmons also. Corners, like I said, we got Nnamdi, or known right now as Default Player from California. David Amerson at NC State. That was one of them I got out of that 10 card gold upgrade as well. Joselio Henson, Texas Tech. Yeah, these guys are basically placeholders until I get something better. Free safety right now. I got Troy Nolan. I got Philip Thomas, who I think was actually playing some linebacker for me since when he did best available, that's where he fit. I just got Taylor Mays. I think he was in that 10 card upgrade too. And Jim Leonard out of Wisconsin. at the strong. I got Dante Whitner, who plays pretty big for me. I like the way he plays. And then at request in my last live stream, Emmanuel Cook. He's done well. I like him as well. My kicker right now is a much lesser Gano card. So I probably should just buy the Beast one. I don't know. And my punter is Brad Norton, and 93 overall will do just fine at that position. So, yay. All right. How many packs down? Just one. We started a little slow, but we're going to pick up the pace here. Because I do want to play a game afterwards. And I want to kind of milk this till noon, because then is when Hurricane's going to start at noon. It's going to we planned a transition from one stream to the other. Will I make a vid when the Operation Sports rosters come out? Yeah, you better believe it. Most definitely will. Okay, so let's open another pack. This is pack number 2. And we start out with a playbook, Western Michigan 4-3D. We got Big Al. Alright, so a collectible we didn't have already. That's good. We're right there. I just upgraded my kicking. Not like awesome or anything, but Randy Bullock will get the starting nod. Loading up on more Michigan boys. James Rogers. Now we got Leon Washington. No, not Leon Sandcastle. Leon Washington out of Florida State. 65 overall halfback. Oh, sweet. We got Navy Stadium. That'll be cool. I'm hoping to get Navy's uniform set, too. I had a request to use them, so it'd be nice to pair the two. 25 game extension. I don't know if Burns is here, but I am. Kellen Moore for the win. 24-hour stream. I don't have one planned yet. I suppose I could talk to Mrs. Nodis Fan and see if there's a way I can pull it off this weekend. But it isn't planned yet. I planned more like, you know, standard length live streams more often was kind of how I was doing it. I wanted to do it for season ticket period right when embargo lifted, but unfortunately, it was out of my control. We had to go out of town. We had something already planned for a weekend away, so it kind of ruined that one. But, yeah. Oh, yeah, I was talking about 12 Central, not 12 Eastern, guys. Sorry, we still have an hour and a half, roughly. A little under an hour and a half left here. Reggie Nelson, free safety, Florida. Okay, so there's our gold card out of this pack. Nice. Can use him if not there, probably another position. Devon House, New Mexico State. And a 75 gamer. Is 94 cam Auburn or Florida? I'm assuming it'd be Auburn. That would make the most sense. Since that's when he did most of his work, right? Okay. So, send everything that belongs in current to current. I'm going to have to watch other items pretty soon. I'm going to be over. I have 5 slots left. I've been kind of, with reserve, you can kind of go back and forth. But I've been kind of loading them up, variety for now. And then to that point where you, of course, you don't have to worry about holding coaches. Because this one doesn't have coaches, so, like Madden does. So at least that frees up some room. These all can go. I'm going to have to check on that corner spot, because that might still, you know what, I'll put him there and see where he fits. Send those reserves. Send that to current. Let's go check the roster before we come back to packs again. do this backwards here. Okay. So there, we've upgraded kicker. It's 25 game, right? Yep, okay. So at the free, he is our top guy now. Okay, so I was holding Jim Leonard for other spots, like going between strong and free, but I've got 88 and 83. Although, that's just too many. Although, look at the with the contract. Oh, they're both down. Let's send him to reserves for now. So corners, yeah, House fits in fine there. And I can drop my lowest. That works for now. I think that was it for new players, right? Let's do a double check. Did the rosters come out? No. There was a note from Steve at Operation Sports on Twitter today saying that they've hit the halfway point and that they're hoping for this for a weekend release. And that's typical. Usually by the weekend or the end of the weekend after release is where they shoot for. I mean, then you got to realize that is a huge project taken on by quite a few people. You know, tackling a conference each or whatever. I mean, think about the sheer number of teams plus the roster size. I mean, you know how many players you're talking about, and you're trying to figure out who new recruits coming in are, you know, who are the incoming freshmen who graduated. It's not as easy as looking at an NFL roster on ESPN.com, you know. I mean, it's there's a lot involved there. And then they're not touching ratings, but, you know, they're trying to get appearances, at least, you know, as far as like skin color down and stuff. So, you know, that's a big job, and we owe those guys a lot of favors, especially since that is all being done for no profit. They're doing that for the sake of the community. So, let's see here. Yeah, so there were no other player changes. Okay, but what I did want to do before my spots fill up here is go into collections with these. So my pen, I don't know what the pending, I'm assuming it's 10 like it always has been with the other, with Madden and stuff, but let's look here. So I started on, I put one away in Lincoln Financial Field. I was a little mad. They took away my Michigan alt that I wanted so bad. When I showed off in my video, the first video, when I showed off collections, there was the Michigan, like the under the lights, like the away alt. And that's no longer there. They switched it up for somebody else. For the stadiums, I guess. So there's Soldier Field and I don't know. I just had to pick something and I'm like, eh. I get enough uniform cards. None of these alts excited me to the point where I had to have them. I'd probably go with West Virginia over any of these. Maybe the South Carolina, because those are pretty sharp. Techs are kind of neat, too, but, you know, whatever. But nothing I had to have, so I'm like, I'll work on a neutral site field. That's what I was doing first, I guess. So I'll go here and go ahead and get these in. Wow, and you get 500 coins back, too. Not bad. Not bad for a mascot. So that's going to put me up over the 20,000 coin mark. Collected. I thought I had Willie Wildcat. Maybe I have him in reserves. So we're looking then. five, six. We still need seven. I know. I swear I have Harry Dog, too. If I look in reserves, I probably do. But the thing is these are the same for each. So, basically, you know, there's no reason to... Wait a sec. Can you do these for all of them? No. Okay, I see. It's just showing that I have them. Or something. Because, like, you know, it's still... Interesting. Okay. So let's see what's in my pending. Anything? Oh. Wait. So if I had them, why wasn't it letting me do them? Oh, it was. I glossed over it because they weren't gold. I see. I'm real bright. So the silvers only get you 100. I get it. Okay. So they're different levels. So I do have half of this then. 3 golds, 2 silvers. Got it. Okay, so that collection's halfway done. Their new collections hit RB and LB. What are the new collections? Or are you asking? Are they in the weekly? I don't really see anything different. Yeah. Okay, can you see if Kylie can make you some? They're in the freezer upstairs. Well, I don't know. She can do them in the microwave for about a minute or a little over a minute. If she can't, I'll do it in a minute, okay? That's Coleman, everybody. Kane is streaming in about an hour. Yeah, he's streaming at noon. We planned this out. He's going to go at noon. The Stanford tree mascot is expensive. Is that the one they deemed rare? What was I going to do? Oh, I was going to go in reserves and see if I had any collectibles. That's what I was going to do. Just the nickname cards. All right, let's do pack number 3. The weekly ones are new? Okay, we'll have to check that in a minute here. The weeklies weren't in yesterday? Oh, they were for me. I don't know. Maybe they took them out and redid them or something. That's interesting, though. Chicken nuggets! Yeah. Oh, they were taken down for a couple days. Thanks, Jamila. I'm just like, this looks the same as it did before to me, but then again, I've had the game for a while, so. There wouldn't be a Hottest Fan stream without Trollman. Oh, so true, right? So true. All right, so North Texas offensive playbook. Whoopee. Oh, Chris. Chris the dog, man. I have a full Auburn uniform set now, home and away. How about that, man? I should just be all Auburn all the time, right? Got an injury recovery card. Aw, man. I got my second Brad Nortman. Ah, that's a bummer. I'll have to see what he's going for. Maybe sell him off and get a different lineman or something of equivalent value. That's why I wish we could trade. Oh, yeah, the quick sell 2,000 coins. Thank you. Luke Stocker out of Tennessee. Have I had to reset my team? No. No, they did it right. They got that part right. Alex Watkins out of Alabama. Christian Ballard, excuse me. I don't know why I want to say Ballard. Ballard out of Iowa. He's a Hawkeye. 81 over D-tackle. Not bad. Brian Hernandez, not to be confused with Aaron Hernandez. And a 50-game extension. Okay. Alrighty. Let's see. Did I have... I had an... I wasn't an A at 71 overall. I might want to replace that. And my second tight end... close. Send those to current. Well, I want to send him to current too because I'll probably auction him. I'd keep a backup, but why? Your punter never gets hurt, and you can just add the contract to the one. Keep him high on contracts. I need to do a Missouri Tigers dynasty? You came from Kane. Hey, welcome. Yeah, I'm doing the early show, and then Hurricane's going to stream at noon. Noon Central, anyway. A little over an hour from now. Did Mutt ever redeem you, the team you lost? Nope. I ended up with two captains, so I mean, it reset, and it was awkward. I had two team captains, but, like, they were supposed to compensate us. Like, C.R. Buick got some compensation, and he's like, trust me, man, they'll hit you up, and I never really did, so even though I prodded them for a while, and I just finally gave up. I mean, it was fine. I used the Jamila the Killer system anyway. He just gave me great cards, so I really had nothing to complain about. Cards and coins. See the trade for the, what was it, 100K for Chimdi Chikwa, and people were like, whoa, he must be rare. So these are just quick sell. Get 2,000 coins out of it. There's a 5,000 variety too. You know what, I'll just keep that injury in reserve. I don't need to carry them on the current. I can move them over when I need them. Is what I'm thinking. Check the roster here. Not as fan, why do you stream on this channel? Because I have a copyright strike currently in dispute or whatever on my Sports Gaming Universe channel. It's not ideal. Obviously, I'd like to stream over there. It probably would mean more people watching, more people noticing that I'm streaming. But unfortunately, I don't have that option until that copyright strike is handled. So I put up a trailer for Infinity Engine from EA, and I usually do my own commentary over it. It was... during the day they announced the Xbox One, and I just put the trailer straight up, and like many other people did, but unfortunately somehow I got a strike. So until that resolves itself, I've got a stream on my second channel, which is my original channel, my non-spin channel. But hey, watch EA take the other Hernandez out. Have I played head-to-head seasons? Yeah. I played two games against Jamila. It was when we were one of the only two people to have the disc. And so it was easy to match up because there's no, like, play friends thing. But we played two games. And I'm going to be posting that video right when I'm done here. So it's all done. It's the next episode of my Ultimate Team. And I will post that. It's not uploaded yet. I'll upload it right when I'm done here while I'm watching Hurricane's stream. And you can see that. It was a couple fun head-to-head games with Jamila, and we never take it real seriously. We have a lot of fun, so there's a couple plays in there that just had us rolling, so. All right. I'm going to go into player here. No, not all. Okay, so first of all, I'm probably not going to be getting too much better of a punter anytime soon, so I can probably just go ahead and assign an extension to him. Since I have a variety of them now, let's give him a 50, because I anticipate him being a starter for quite a while, but you never know, a better card may come around. Did I give it to the wrong person? No, okay. So then, now, I'm taking my own advice here. I want to see what the market is for him before I post him out there. So D-tackle, tight end, wide receiver is what I need to look at. Send an A to reserves. It's marginal, but the contracts are better on Hernandez now since he's full up. Okay, so these guys are even, but Cumberland's Stocker right now has got the contract on him, so we'll go do this. What was the other position? Maybe I did them all already. Oh, it's D-tackle. Well, you know, you usually play two at a time in a 4-3. Guys get injured at those positions sometimes, so not that often, but all right. Roll with that. Just curious when I do lineup now, when I do best lineup. Yeah, still an 89. I didn't think I'd change much yet. Haven't added that anybody with that much impact. Just a point different here or there, except in our kicking. Huh, funny. He's a 93 overall punter, but yet you put him in at punter and he's 94? I don't get that. I'll do this for Chris for the time being. We'll go all Auburn in a Vandy Stadium with Michigan playbooks. And that'll change our theme. Yep. Okay, let's get back at PAX here. Not as I saw some people with 95 overall teams with almost 200K in coins and they had already finished this whole season. Wow. Not as you think they should have transfer and road to glory? Definitely. Definitely. Is Hurricane streaming? Hurricane is streaming in an hour. We're both on Central Time. He's going to go at noon Central. It's 11 o'clock Central right now. One more hour. Trust me, we planned this. I'm going to lead right into his. We're good like that. We're going to give you nonstop entertainment. We're not going to make you wait 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes. No, we're going to end one and go right into another. This time we're leading off with a game extension. 50 games. Deontay Thompson, Florida. Another Boise guy, Chris Carr. Colin Baxter. So I don't need a center. I need guards. I got the leprechaun, baby. There's six of the 10. He's one of the 500 ones, too, the golds. 25 game extension. And we got Big Al again, which is okay, because we'll just put him to another set. Yeah, baby, DeSean Jackson. Okay, I like that. I like that a lot. 96 speed, 89 agility. Yeah, sweet. Add DeSean Jackson to my wide receiving core. And that North Texas Stadium. It's kind of an interesting end zone piece there. I might want to try that one out. And Chris Harris from Kansas. Okay. I can live with that pack, definitely. It's going to be too much to move over all at once. Let's see what this says. Huh. Filled up all my others, so I'll have to move some of those that I'm not going to be using. I don't think Carr fits into free safety, but maybe he'd double at another spot. I'm just going to go ahead and put them to reserve for now. And then I am going to look. I want to look at auction really quick on my punter. Oops. I like this too. This, like, where you can, they've got the mix and match quarterback or wide receiver. Just defense, just offense. You know, that's nice. Because sometimes you don't want to look specifically for a position. You just want your defense to get better or something, you know, and then that's awesome. Hold on, guys. I'm just going to send out a tweet here telling people we're here doing this. You've got speed now. Run some reverses. I might have to. I told you Dwayne Harris was good. Yeah, he is. He's been good for me. You'll see in the next video if you didn't watch the live stream. Okay, punter. 90-94. Oh, not much out here. Really? Really? Wow. So, if I drop him for 10, will somebody bite on that since it's a lot lower? I wonder what my buddy Jamila would say. He's a buy. I can drop him for 15,000, but I don't want him to sit there all day. I want him to actually get bought. And you got this guy at 9. Yeah, I think I'm going to go like 9,000 on him or something like that. Because I could definitely use that towards another position, then that would be great. Let's do that. And here's where I'll show you. You can definitely do this for 1 or 2 hours. Okay, so obviously we're not going to quick sell. We're going to do auction block. He only costs 100 points to post up, too. Nice. Okay, so we're going to do buy it now at 1 coin cheaper than the other punter that was on there. It wasn't him, but it was another 93 overall.2 hours sounds good. Since we do have to pay to post it, I'm gonna make it 3 maybe. just to give it that extra time. Now I did do the one with less contract, I hope. Yes, good. Otherwise I wasted a contract card. Okay, so that's out there. Hopefully that'll get bought. I don't know how in-demand punters are, but there certainly weren't many out there. It'll sell for $8K. Yeah, I probably should have done $8. We'll see. We'll see if this sells. If not, I'm only out 100 coins. Oh, you know what I was going to do? I was going to... get those collectibles out of there so I have room in the other category. And maybe clear out a couple other things in there. Is there any point in keeping a nickname on? I mean, it doesn't do anything for your actual team, right? Other than collections, or... I mean, like, I don't think there's an actual slot that does anything for a nickname, though, for your team, though. And if that's the case, then these are going to reserves until I know which collection I need them for or whatever. No sense in carrying them. Injuries. Oh, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Honestly, I don't need that many active injury cards either. Send those to reserves for later. Pull them when I need them, because, I mean, why fill those slots when you can have that for variety in stadium and uniform? I'm going to apply. I've been waiting to open these packs to apply game extensions because I don't want to give the 75s to people who I'm just going to replace. Guys in their 90s that I knew that would pretty much be around. And I'm going to keep all these in here for now. I like the variety in uniform and in stadiums as well. A nice little collection of stadiums so far. Some variety to use there. It's always nice if you're going to play a lot of games in this mode to have some different scenery now and again. As far as playbooks, I don't really think I need different versions of 4-3 defenses, but maybe the offense ones will be good to keep. Okay. So we'll do that. We'll go back into packs here. Oh, announcers refer to your nickname in-game. Okay. Yeah. Whatever. Not that big a deal. Yeah, baby, I got the Toledo home uniform. I think I already have the darks. I can run an all-Coleman Rocket team now. Yes. It sold? Nice. Okay. Oh, yeah, 33,000 coins. Nice. Yeah, like I said, I probably could have gotten more for it, but, I mean, I don't need to gouge here. I'm just trying to run a solid strategy, so. Tony Clemens, Colorado. Antoine Reed, Pittsburgh. $50 game extension. Another $50 game extension. Oh. Yeah, the records for every record stink in this game. I mean, I don't know why they can't use real ones. I mean, even if they can't use the name, they should be able to represent the real records. Penn State offensive playbook. Okay. Ben Bass, a 60 overall left end. That's not going to be very helpful. Oh, that is though, baby. Jamila, I got my very own CJ Spiller now. 89 overall. Nice. There's got to be some acceleration and speed here. 96 speed, 97 acceleration, 89 elusiveness, 83 carry. Okay. Yeah. CJ Spiller, welcome. Ole Miss Stadium. Okay, we're moving up. We got some big name stadiums here now. And Bryant Browning. Believe it or not, that probably is my best right guard right now. Okay, so let's take the guys we know can make a difference. Actually, I think he'll be my best last wide receiver or second to last wide receiver. Keep the Toledo uniforms for the time being. Current. Okay, as far as the Penn State offensive playbook, I'm not terribly in a rush to use that. I'll put it to reserves right now. Okay. Let's go look and see what we have. Let's try to player, not all. There you go. Okay, at the halfback spot. This is looking good. He's actually... You know, okay, that's another thing. I think Jerome Harrison got bumped too, because I believe he was, I know, if you go back and watch my video, he was an 89 when I pulled him. He was an 89, and I think they just went through and they had some realizations that a couple guys should have different ratings. And so that's fine. That's fine. You know, I mean, like, he probably was an 87 at the time the game released, but I had it early, so... I'm one of the only people who would have noticed that. But, yeah. Nadas, why do some YouTubers do YouTube for a living? Because this is more fun than any other job that I'd have to go punch a clock for. I don't know, that's one reason. This is a passion of mine, doing videos, making videos, interacting with people. I love this. You know, why wouldn't you do something that you like for a job? I mean, you know, if you're not, you should. You should try, at least. If there's any opportunity to do so, you should. Anything you have a passion for, I think someone would have to think about doing something like that. If it were an opportunity for them. Okay, so, I don't know. I had some returns for touchdowns with Bo, but that was on freshman level. I don't know. I gotta put one of these guys away. Barry's more elusive. I guess I don't have to put one of these guys away, but... I don't know. I think I'm going to put Barry away for now. Just because it's getting a little crowded in here. Could use an upgraded fullback. That I got to say. So there we go. DeSean Jackson fits in very nicely now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep, that's too many. Hernandez is not going to go to reserves. I say I had 8. Yeah, because now I'm running with 7. It's kind of a lot, but I'll go with it for now until I need spaces. We'll see. Now, I didn't need him at right guard, but he can play. He can slide over to left guard and be my best player there. And unfortunately, I don't think I can delete him, because I think you have to have a player at each position, so, as a placeholder. Have anyone else I had to figure out in here? I don't think so. You know what, though? There's no way Curtis Lofton is playing. No reason for him to take up that spot. Does he translate to a corner place, maybe? I'll keep Chris Harris around for right now. Again, until I need the spot. Alright, so my extra Brad Nortman did me good. Got me roughly 10,000 coins for auction. I'm surprised it didn't give me a note down at the bottom here that it sold. Why is that not updating? Usually the news will update and they'll tell you down at the bottom. Oh, there it is. I had to go out to the main screen. Thank you, RBK87 Hockey. I'm assuming that stands for Reebok. Who knows? The winner of my Brad Nortman 93 overall punter. Congrats, bro. So, Mr. Hurricane sent me here. Well, welcome. I'm going to be sending everybody over to Mr. Hurricane when I'm done. Do I know when Hurricane will start the countdown? Trust me, he's starting at noon Central in 43 minutes. You're not going to miss Kane. I'm going to be ending right before Kane's stream. You're not going to miss him. I know that's some anxiety, but don't worry. Oh, guys. It's funny. Okay, collections real quick here. Oh, neat. That sorted that on how many were done. Because I think that was in the middle before. That's cool. Okay. Then what would be my next choice? Probably a uniform. I don't know. Maybe I'll... won't commit it yet. Wait and see if something else gets added. When will it end? My stream? Or his? I don't know when his is going to end. My stream is going to end in about 40 minutes here, right before Hurricane starts. Two more packs. We'll at least get to part of a game before we're out of here, I think. I think. Maybe we'll do an offline challenge just because it'll be easier to get through shorter quarters or something. Chris Conte, California. Britton Colquitt, a much worse punter. Another 4-3 defensive playbook, this time Colorado State. 75 game extension. 5 game injury recovery. Western Kentucky Stadium. What did I rate this game? I gave it a 9 out of 10. And you can follow to the link right in the description of this video. There's the link to my review, so go check it out. I rated it a 9 out of 10 because I felt that this is the strongest offering of the series to date. Hi.
Sorry to bother you, but Kuma keeps on bothering me about chicken nuggets.
Okay. Are you able to run the microwave?
Yeah, but where are the chicken nuggets?
Okay, the chicken nuggets are in a bag on the freezer, kind of like where you find the pizza rolls. And if you could just put some on a paper plate and heat it up for about a minute and 30 seconds.
Okay.
So one. 3-0 and then start. Okay, thanks, hon.
You're welcome.
My girl Kylie. The Georgia jerseys are nice. I might have to check that out. Do I think NCAA 14 is worth buying? Definitely. Read my review here. That is, just right, go to the About section of this video. The link is right there. You can read exactly my thoughts on the game better than I can sit here and just tell you briefly. Okay. Jared Odrick from Penn State. Anyway, my reasoning is that, I mean, this is the best offering of the series to date. I feel hands down. And the reason I say that is gameplay is much improved. The physics engine is great. The cuts on the right stick with running backs is wonderful. And Ultimate Team is in. I mean, you know, they've really... And you can read what my one nitpicky thing is. I'm not really thrilled with power recruiting. I felt like it was a change kind of just for change's sake and not necessarily better than the old system. I love the new coach skill stuff, though. That role-playing element of that is awesome. Kiwanuka, Boston College. Meh. I still would have preferred... I would have preferred a good fullback. I would have preferred a good guard. Put him on the left side here over a right end. I think I'm already pretty good at that spot. Oh, well. Maybe I can work a deal with something here. Barry Church, Toledo. Cool. Arkansas away uniform. Not bad. Not sure that would count down on a microwave, though. When you type that in, that's how it works, sir. It converts, trust me. Mine does. Okay, so I guess I'll at least give them a look and see where they fit in. Game extension, yes. Once again, I filled up my other... I'm always afraid I'm going to discard things I don't want to discard. Arkansas has black jerseys. Yeah, I noticed that. I noticed that when I went through the, when I was looking through uniforms. So. Okay. Before we open that last pack, current roster. Right end and D tackle is what we're looking at here. Oh, he is the best I have. Okay. Well, I won't complain. That means this guy's definitely going to reserves. How am I at left end? And how am I at D-tackle? Yeah, these guys don't all need to be here. /83. Thank you, go, buddy. There we go. Should work. And then, oh, but I need to look at my others. Since that's full, and I know I'll be getting more here in the next pack. Again, I don't see any reason. I mean, you carry more than one or two of these at a time. For injury. Game extensions. I should just apply some game extensions to my better guys here. that would take that number down. Again, I'm saving some for, you know, much better players, obviously longer ones, but just to ensure that I'll be playing for a while here. Yeah, not you. Definitely Spiller. Give him a 50. What do I got on Santana Moss? 36. Let's get Deshaun. Start Deshaun out with a 25. Let's hold off on the rest of those guys because I could improve. I'd give it to Salas if anybody here, but I'll wait. Tight end. Yeah, I already did Keekly. He had 100 when I started with him. I don't know. Some of these guys, it's like once you bump, it's like all of a sudden, like, I don't think I should have given it to him yet, so maybe I'll hold off on a lot of these. Is there a can't miss? You know what? Wintner's getting it, though, because I like this guy. Played big for me. Definitely not putting into my kicker, and I already put into my punter. So that's good for now. And I've got depth enough that I can move guys around if I have issues, but I shouldn't have issues fielding a team. So let's go, we'll do this last pack and see where we're at here. What's my team's overall? It was an 89. Let me just check with best available though. Still an 89. Although, why do you make him? No, there's no way he's the best. There, I'm a 90 once I put Browning in where he should have been. I'm surprised it didn't catch that. Maybe it's an awareness issue. I don't know. But still, I think if he's a right guard, he can translate to left guard pretty well. Yeah, I agree with the wide receivers, tight end, yes. Yep. Santana, no, he's not better. I feel like I want speed back there, though. I don't really want to get DeSean Jackson hurt, but I want him back there. Doing that, so I'm a 90 now. Okay. Last pack of this stream, anyway. Marcus Kuhn. That's the wrong Kuhn. I want John Kuhn. Although I gotta tell Jamila there's a Marcus Kuhn, so he can make an all Kuhn team. Another Boise guy. Not a guy that's going to play for me, but another Boise guy. Yes, I have Chris Harris. Brian Orakpo, nice. Again, a position that, well, I mean, it'll be an upgrade. I still would have preferred a guard on offense, but I've noticed from auctions they're kind of rare anyway, so. Okay. Brian Orakpo, 90 overall. 50 game extension. Virginia Tech 4-3D. Maybe it's time to upgrade our 4-3. Although Michigan's, it's got to be pretty good. Brandon Bolden out of Ole Miss. Not really a piece I can use right now, but not a terrible card.
Huh, that's one of my first repeats. I don't think I've had a repeat yet, which is pretty crazy because I've opened a few packs. Oh, I take that back. Norton, the punter, was my first repeat. Other than these cards, I've had Big Al a few times. Kentucky's away uniform. And a 25 game extension. Nice. Okay, so. Send those to current. Virginia Tech 4-3. I guess there's no real reason to have that lineup, so we'll do that. Do our last adjustments here. Find a quick game we could play. I already had 85 Anthony Spencer, but obviously these guys can move around. So he's a guy I would like to put some contract into. A game extension, excuse me. What? Oh, that's right. You gotta let him actually settle in. You gotta get out of here. Let them officially settle to the lineup or to the roster. Then you gotta go back and do it.
Getting rid of it this time, and since I still have 5 current player slots, I'm good. I'll look at my others here. Two, three, four, five, six, 75 game extensions. 550s. 125. Oh, I still want to roll with all these uniforms? I suppose I should, since I still have the slots. Yeah, I do have Toledo home and road. Yeah. Nice. Although, to play a game in them, you have to set it as your main one anyway. Bolden goes in the SEC collection? Oh, nice. I'll go do that. That's one thing I'm not very good at paying attention to, is which one of those guys are in the conference collections and stuff. Collecting a guy is great, because then you still get the discard value and it goes towards something. Always like that. Thanks for the heads up on that one. Oh, that's cool. They tell you who you have, even if they're in reserve, so you can go back and get them. I love that. Why doesn't Madden do that, or does Madden do that now? Because, I mean, obviously I don't have him ready to put away, but it still tells me if I have them. I love that. Beautiful. Let me just look on. Wait, or is that the case? It's telling me I have Jarrell Harris too. Yeah, probably. I have Pryor too,
but he's in my lineup. So, or is he? I know I have Pryor. Do I have Martellus Bennett? Does that mean I have them or not when they're highlighted like that? Maybe it does. Chaney here. I mean, if so, I've got about half this collection. If I had Martellus Bennett, why was I not playing him, though? Because that'd be, like, my best tight end. I'm confused. I saw a 60-something rated Tom Brady in the auction house. I saw that one.
I haven't seen a higher rated, like regular rating Tom Brady.
Collections are not worth it. You get a varsity pack, which sucks. Nah, you know, I still like doing collections. I mean, yeah, you're right. Varsity pack is not a great deal, but if it's a guy I'm not going to play, realistically, my reserves at any time, eh, whatever. Unless you can get more for him for selling him on the auction house, then. So did this automatically? I love that. Once you have it in, it resorts, like, by how many you have. That's brilliant. It's a little touch, but it's nice. Okay, so now if I could only. Can I please do it by conference? Can I say just say SEC players? That'd be great. I can do this way though. Let's see. Maybe I. Wait, this can't be right. It just not doesn't work when I do it that way. No, I don't have Martellus Bennett. So what's the deal? Why were those highlighted? See, I would have thought that would have been really slick
if that's what it actually meant, but I guess not. Oh, the collections, I guarantee you, they'll get better, don't you think? I think they will.
I think they will. Anyway, I think I had a few of those guys that were in that SEC collection, but I'd have to look around. So, alright, so we're going to manage the current lineup to put Arakpo in. Right there. Get better at any of these spots. No, I think we're good. Oh, we're good. So we bumped to a 90 overall during the stream from 89. I'm gonna save this lineup. Better at a few positions. Added depth at wide receiver, at running back. Maybe it's the rare card to that collection? Maybe. Hmm. Yeah, I'd be interesting to get some clarification on that. Oh, and I also want to go in and do... get rid of these two... I already did Big Al in this one, so it'd be in another one. Chris the Dog said the Georgia ones are nice. Maybe I'll go with that. Kind of like Carolina's too, but yeah, let's go with the Georgia. Let's do it for Sam Slater. I mainly just want to get the 500 coins. Let's work on Soldier Field too, why not? Have more neutral sites to play at. Alright, so we made it to just a shade under. We went from 19,000 coins when we started the stream to almost 35, and a lot of that came by selling a punter for just about 10. And... yeah, so, but don't leave yet, guys, because we got another 15 minutes leading up to Hurricane Stream. And, let's see what I can do here. I don't know that we can attack a game. Let's look at the auction house and see what we can maybe either buy and sell or snag for ourselves. If there's enough separation in the Mannings there. What was a position in need for me? Fullback. And I don't think there are any other 95 to 99 fullbacks, because I noticed that. Is there a 90 to 94 fullback? Oh, okay. Anybody realistically priced? I don't think I want to pay 8,000 for a fullback. I just don't think so. Whoops. What else did I need? Left guard, right? I want the Hutchinson is what I want. Yeah, ouch. That's why I'm having trouble upgrading there. There just aren't many. My best center is an 80. could upgrade there for about 8,000. Right guard area, I'm already at 87. Right tackle, I'm good. What? How about left tackle?
Yeah, Hurricane's going to stream in 15 minutes. Or roughly there. I must not have looked here for the Jake Longs and everything. Whoa, who's this? 3,000. I like the sound of that a little more. The next Monroe is 5,000. I'm buying that one way or another. And for that price, I might just hang on to it.
There wasn't like a huge... I'd like to have Khalil, but I'm not going to pay Khalil prices right now. What's the cheapest Khalil out there? Joe Thomas jumps. I don't like how it bounces you off of the pay it now. I'll buy it now. I'd love a Jake Long, since I'm a Michigan fan and all. And he's 94. So that's what I was kind of hoping to pull a really good lineman in this stream, but it's okay. We can work. So for 3,000, I think I probably can't. You kidding me? They're doing Sandcastle? I didn't even see that. In the college game, too? Really? I don't know. I mean, I was one of the first to jump on the Sandcastle thing doing my series and stuff, but it's getting a little much now. You're gonna put them into the college game, too? Should have taken Hudson. That's right, I already was 85 overall there. But he should be able to slide over now. Oh, he only had 11. Nah, I'm going to take care of the contract here anyway, so. Sorted that for nothing because I gotta sort it again. Glad I held out on Riley though. I was gonna give him contract before. What ruined Madden? Accident with the graphics, huh? Do I play NHL Ultimate Team? Yeah, I do. Oh, the sandcastle was an accident, or what? When's the next Sam Slinger and Quarter Pounder? I don't know exactly, Padres. I'm going to have to work them in there, though. Honestly, I'm probably going to do some baseball before that happens. I wanted to line up, not this. Or, yeah. Yeah, much better. There we go. I'm liking my line a little more after that move. Because then I slide Riley over to the left guard. I do want an upgraded center. I was kind of looking at the Pouncey card. That's what's a 94 overall or whatever.
I don't understand what Leon Sandcastle, even, you know, the concept of Leon Sandcastle has anything to do with college football. Nothing. Twenty-five minutes till hurricane, and when did he just tweet that now? I could go a little long if he's not ready. Okay, yeah, 1 minute ago, I see it. I'll go a little long then. I'll wait till he's ready. I'm not going anywhere anyway. So, yeah, stick around here a few more minutes then. He's not in the game? Good. What is the percent chance that Lando goes to San Diego State? Well, I like San Diego State from having done that series with them before my coaching carousel. Or no, not coaching carousel. Whatever dynasty I did with San Diego State. But it will, a lot of it will depend on like what string they offer and stuff. When is the next UMass? That's another one that's got to come out real soon. I really got to get to that. It's going to be painful going back to NCAA 13, though, with the running backs not being able to cut the way they are here in the physics engine. I'm just saying it is. I've got some ideas to maybe bring UMass into NCAA 14. Somebody had the suggestion of why don't you just redo like your roster as it stands when you finish like this current season and then bring them in. I think the idea is brilliant. I just have to see if I can actually execute it correctly to the point where I'm happy with it. Because I would really love to do that. Because they got new uniform sets that they wore last year. You know, much, much more stuff with that. Yeah, I'd love to have them in NCAA 14 for not only for the game engine, but for the uniforms, the whole thing, and continue it. And then I would also do a brand new one as well, so... yeah. So anyway, that's very much what I'd like to accomplish with UMass. We'll see if I can pull it off or not. Here I am, not searching for anybody. I really want that, I have to have I have to have my boy sooner than later here. Laurinaitis. Oh, now the cheapest one is 20. They keep going up. I could have had one for 10 yesterday. See, that's what I'm talking about. The market is dynamic, guys. Just because they're one price one day doesn't mean you can go back and for sure get that. Why is Kane stream private? Because he's still setting it up, probably. Thanks for waiting on Kane. No problem. Shoot, though. I could have had one of these for 10, and even if I wanted to resell it today, I could have made profit on it. I don't want Teo. I mean, I'll take him at some point if I get him in a pack, but I'm not going to spend coin on Teo. If these guys are the same rating, I'm taking my boy James from Wayzata. I was hoping that maybe they'd have more Wayzata alums in here, like a Marion Barber card or... Has anyone seen anybody from Minnesota? I mean, while I'm on the topic, I mean, any Maroney, Barber? I mean, I guess they're both out of the league now, so that's tricky for them. I guess Laurinaitis maybe is only the only current Wayzata player. Ben Hamilton's out of the league now. Shoot, I really would have liked that. Build up a, you know, I was like, who else is in the league? Oh, Decker. I'd imagine Eric Decker would have a card, wouldn't he? Anybody seen an Eric Decker? I need Minnesota guys. Who's Lando? Lando Lakes, my running back. I did him long ago on this very channel, the Nautis Fan channel. You can find the playlist, as a matter of fact, if you go to the main page of this channel. The channel page. I brought him back for NCAA 14. He's my Road to Glory player. finish the season you're in with UMass, and if you win the national championship and the series there. Yeah, that's a very real possibility as well. Have any of you guys heard of De La Salle High School? If you're talking about in Minnesota, yes. Not that far away from me here. Someone put a Laurinaitis up for 150 buy it now yesterday, but the streamer couldn't get it in time. That sucks. Yeah. That stuff will happen once and again, you know, once and again, but the problem is being on the spot to not only see it, but get it. I do really wish that trades were still in. Or I shouldn't say still in. Made it into this. It's in Madden, obviously. You think a Decker's a high 80? Yeah, see, I'd love to have him as, like, my third receiver, like, my possession receiver. Like, you know, I mean, granted, obviously, at some point I'll probably have all 90s receivers, but Decker, I can read Decker, Bennett, and Spaeth. Oh, okay. That's it? I guess, I mean, I don't know. You have to have pro players, so. And we are the Golden Gophers. We don't, under Mason, we sent him out, like I said, Maroney, Barber, Ben Hamilton. You know, yeah, I think the Sandcastle banner was meant for Madden. I don't know how it got in here. Decker's an 82. Ooh, that's kind of low. Well, you know what? I'm gonna search him though. Because if he's cheap, I'll take him. Just to have him represent. Plus, at this point, I might as well get him now while I can still play him in the series. Oh, only one? Shit, 10,000? Come on, you're killing me. No, not 10,000. I do want him. I don't want to pay 10,000 for him. Shoot. I almost want to do it just to do it, but I don't want to. I'm going to be sitting here spamming the Eric Deckers for, like, no apparent reason. Until I get one I can afford. I tell you, when Decker was at the U, he's an absolute beast. I mean, I think I would have rated him a little higher, 80. I think, to do him a service, I think Decker's more an 85, 86, but that's just me. You know, plus, considering how he's turned out in the pros here now. Yeah. Okay, in a few minutes I will help you with that. Just unlocked Charles Woodson from Michigan. Which collection unlocks? Oh, is that in the skills trainer? Come on, man. Why, look at all the Missouri players. I could do that. That is kind of cool that you can just search, yeah, by school. Well, obviously, you should be able to. Rucker, Brad Smith, Tim Barnes, Chase Kaufman, Denario Alexander, Andrew Gackler, Michael Agnew, Jeremy Maclin, Sheldon Richardson, Sean Weatherspoon, that's a nice card right there. CJ Mosley, definitely a nice card. Chase Daniel. Blaine Gabbert. Dominique Hamilton. I don't believe Kane is streaming yet. He said he's 15 to 20 minutes still, I think. South Carolina players.
Let me sort this by their overall. Okay. Jonathan Joseph. And a 90 overall corner. That's a nice card.
Sid! I gotta get me a Sid Rice sometime.
What is Sid going for? Not too bad. 7. Oh wait, there were more than just that. I consider somebody wants to. Okay, this is an example of what you should not do. Don't go put Sidney Rice up for 25,000 when there's one for 7. Okay? That's a sure way to not sell your card. Okay. Rant over. I'm just saying, people ask for tips. That's one of the best tips I can give you. Don't overvalue your cards. If they're sentimental to you, then keep them. If you think everybody else thinks Sidney Rice is worth 25,000 coins, then you're a little delusional. I mean, I guess there is that, you know, hey, just in case there's a run on them, and, you know, but whatever. I'm not really naming off everybody, I'm just kind of going through here, sorry. Ah, oh, there you go. Somebody asked yesterday, is Marcus Lattimore in the game? And I did not know what to answer at the time, but here you go. Marcus Lattimore is in the game. Can you imagine no injury what Marcus Lattimore would be rated? I mean, he's got to be... Oops, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to flip the card.
89 speed, 87 agility, 91 accuracy. That's pretty good for an 85 overall card, don't you think? Man, oh man, Mark. What's he going for? 6. I screwed this up. I gotta put this back how it was. Okay, I'll get back to Lattimore. Tell me. What is a Lattimore for 2,500? I feel like I want that card. Alshon Jeffrey. Torrey Gurley. Darian Stewart. God, I don't know. I kind of want that Lattimore.
Hold on, guys.
Does he really play it all for me, though? God, I don't know.
It's not like there's a run on him or anything. Somebody put him out there for a grand, and he's mine.
Kids are starting to get restless. I can hear it now. He'd be a 90-something without the injury. Yeah, exactly. It's heartbreaking for that guy. You know, and it'd probably be just fine. But, I mean, like, you know, when that happened, it's like, really? Again? You got to be kidding me. So I need to, I know you guys are all saying your teams and everything, but I need me a fullback. What, did I already look at that? I already looked at that, didn't I? To get a top flight, yeah, it was going to cost me like 8, right? Yeah. There's less of them now. They're disappearing. What other position do I really need? Wait. Limited time bronze upgrade collections. Huh? Complete this collection of bronze playbooks from packs and receive one silver. Oh. I see what you mean. I'm like, I thought this was some free promotion that was going on or something. Okay, so I most need, what could make my team better with one move? Let's see if I may. I'm looking at the wrong position. I want to see lineup. I always go backwards of what I need. Okay. If I could make my team better with one move, yeah, fullback's pretty low, but I mean, you know, how often do you use your fullback? You use it in goal line running sets. I mean, you use the fullback, but I mean, you know, what I'm saying is a lot of times you spread the field and don't even have the fullback on the field. So, center. You know, I'm pretty happy with wide receiver, tight end for right now. Left outside linebacker be nice. A second middle linebacker, which is why I want that Laurinaitis so bad. Third corner, but you know. So I'd say kicker. Center, kicker, I still have room to be better at left guard, definitely. I'm all these positions, obviously, but center, kicker. Left outside linebacker, middle. Okay. Hurricane in 7 minutes, you. Yeah. Hurricane in 7 minutes. Yes, I'm excited too. Okay. So with our positions of need, what am I looking at? A middle linebacker? Like, does Laurinaitis just have a regular card? Jones for just under 6. Oh, he does. He does have a regular card. I'll be darned. I'm going to have both versions, I tell you. Any and all Laurinaitis cards that come out, I have to be all over. Gotta represent Wayzata. I'm doing it. Represent my school. Gotta have him in my lineup. I probably could have waited for a little cheaper, but that's okay. Feel better about that. shoot. I don't want to get too low on coins, so I still have some room to buy low, sell high on some stuff that isn't bargain basement to make more coins. So, I like that. Save that lineup, definitely. Yeah, sometimes, it's hard to bounce Luke out, but I'd like to run a double Laurinaitis middle linebacker. I'd like to run Laurinaitis across the linebacker slots, but look up Dion. Clear my messages here first. So I don't get confused later.
He's got to be in. What's his overall? Do we know? I want a Janikowski card. Just because I do. Hauschka's 4,500K, 5,000. Now, like, there is the difference between one Kading to another is quite a bit, but will somebody pay for that is the question. When you can just pay about as much for this card, because there's so many of them. Tempted to just grab one of these, but I thought maybe I'd get one in packs today, since they seem to be pretty spread out.
Braylon Edwards, I want that card for many reasons. Because he's from Michigan, first off, and he's a beast.
So, I could probably afford him now. I saw one for 20 today, but I don't really want to spend all my coins on him.
So, we're getting really close to Hurricane Stream, guys. So, it's been a lot of fun. And as soon as I get information that he started, I'm probably going to end mine, because I got some kids to feed and watch after here and some videos to upload. So I'm really glad we got to do this. This was pretty dang sweet, and very cool you guys to stop in and watch this morning. It's kind of fun to do a morning stream. I'm gonna have to do more of these. I think we proved that it could be quite entertaining. So who says we have to wait till afternoon or evening to do it, right? We can do these in the morning. I'm kind of digging this. So I hope you guys had fun. And we will see you guys soon for another stream. I don't know, maybe I'll stream tonight or something. We'll see how things go. So I hope you guys had fun. Go check out Mr. Hurricane's stream if you weren't planning to already. He's late. I'll wait another minute or two then. If someone can give me confirmation when he's there, I don't want to leave you guys hanging. I want you to be able to go simultaneously from one to another, you know? And if you haven't already, please leave a like on the way out. I'd really appreciate it. If you enjoyed the stream, if you want more Ultimate Team and NCAA 14 action, definitely check out Sports Gaming Universe, my main channel. Pasta Padre has a roster set on his account. It's probably not a full roster, but he started. Okay. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Definitely, once again, a lot of fun. I'm going to watch some of Hurricane's stream while I upload some stuff. And I'll see you guys over there. Thanks for joining me. Take it easy, guys.